If you've purchased Affinity Publisher, then you already know what a powerful design tool it is for creating your low-content books. But because it's so feature-packed, it's likely that you haven't figured out how to use some of the best parts yet. By the end of this video, you're going to have an exact idea of what master pages are and how you can use them to help streamline your design process when creating your interior manuscript files. Now, once again, if you want advice on how to create a passive income business selling low-content books on the Kindle Direct Publishing platform, then make sure to subscribe and hit the bell so that you can get notified every time I put out one of these videos, which is every Monday. So what are master pages and why are they useful anyways? Well, what master pages allow you to do is essentially repeat certain elements throughout the document so that you don't have to create them multiple times. So I'm talking about things like headings, page numbers, or certain design elements that you might want to appear across either the entire document on every page or just a specific number of pages within that document. Now, what this ultimately does is just make the design process a lot quicker, a lot more streamlined, and if you need to go in and make any updates, you can just do the update once in that one master page, and then the update will display throughout the entire document or however many pages you've got that master page applied to. So before we flip the screen here, let me know, have you been using Affinity Publisher and did you know about master pages? Have you used them before, or is this a feature that you knew was there but you just didn't quite know how to use them? Let me know in the comments below. All right, now I'm gonna flip the screen and we'll take a quick look at how master pages actually work in Affinity Publisher. All right, so here we are in Affinity Publisher and we've got all of our pages aligned over to the left here. Now this is just a very, very basic gratitude journal. As you can see, we've got all the pages over here on the left and then we've got our master page up at the top left here. Now, as you can see, what I've done here on the master page has applied to all of the pages in my document. So whatever change I make to this master page is now going to update every single page in the document. So let's go ahead and just make a little bit of a change here just so I can show you what I'm talking about. Let's just give this a bit of a heading. All right, so we'll just do a little bit of font change here just to make things a little bit more interesting. All right, so you can see now I've created this heading on this one side and I'm just going to move it over to the other side as well. Just do a quick copy and paste here. And you'll see as I move down these pages that that heading is now showing up on all of the other pages in my document. Now, another thing master pages is really used for is creating page numbers. So let's go ahead and do that just so you can see how to apply page numbers. So first you're going to create your text box, and I'm not going to worry about making this perfect right now, but once you've got your text box, you'll go up to text, insert fields, page number. So again, you can go ahead and give that any styling that you want. We'll just bring that down in size a notch. We'll just center that. We will align that to the page as well. Right, and then we'll just copy and paste that over to the other side. Line that up. And now you can see as I'm scrolling down, we've got all of our numbered pages. Super quick and very handy. Now, another cool thing you can do is create multiple master pages. So we've already got our first one here, but what if we want to create some design elements that appear only on a few of the other pages. What we can do is just go ahead and click on this button here to add a master. We'll just leave that as Master B, and then we'll click OK. Now, perhaps we've got maybe a graphic that we want to include as a watermark or something like that. So we can go ahead and place a graphic. And maybe I want that in the bottom right corner of some of the pages. And maybe we want to just rotate it a little bit like that. Okay, now you can see that that hasn't applied to our pages yet, and that's fine. Okay, so now I'm just going to right click on the Master B thumbnail here. I'm going to go to Apply Master to Pages, and then I've got a few choices here. I can either choose all pages, odd pages, even pages, or I can just specify which pages I want this butterfly to show up on. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in a couple of random pages here just to show you what we can do. The other thing to pay attention to here is this replace existing. So if you want this to actually replace the existing master page that has been applied to pages 3 and 7, then you would click this. I still want to keep those spaces to write down your three things you're grateful for. I want the butterfly to go on top, so I'm going to make sure that this is unticked, and then I'll go ahead and hit OK. And now you can see that the butterfly has shown up just on those couple of pages that I've specified. Now, obviously, you can see here I've just used a JPEG that hasn't had the background removed, and that's creating this interruption in the lines. We wouldn't want that on a finished product, but just to show you what we can do here. Now, what if we want to make a change to one of these pages that has a master applied to it, but we don't want to upset the rest of the pages? Well, we can make changes to just a single page, even if it has a master page applied to it. So I can go ahead and just click on a page here. Then I'm going to go over to the Layers panel. I'm going to right click on the master layer that I want to see a change for. Actually, let's pick a different page here, one without a butterfly. All right, so we've got this page here. Now I'm going to go ahead and right click on the master layer. And I'm going to click Edit Detached. So I'm going to go ahead and click, and I'm just going to remove all of this stuff. So now I can go ahead and click Finish up top here. And now I've removed that one section, and you can see that none of the other pages that have the master pages applied have been disturbed. So for this example, maybe we just want to add a quote. Right, so again, you'd obviously want to be a lot more thoughtful than what I'm doing here, but you get the idea. Now, what do you do when you want to remove a master page? So we've got our little mini gratitude journal here, but you can see on the first page, we probably don't want to put that on our first page. We might want a dedication page or something like that. So all we need to do here is just right-click on that page, and we can hit Clear Masters. So that's just going to remove it right from our page, and we can go ahead and put whatever we want on the front here. And And then we can go ahead and add a line. All right, so that's master pages. Now, if you want some more helpful tutorials on Affinity Publisher, there's a channel called Affinity Revolution, and they've got lots and lots of really helpful tutorials. So that's another great resource that you can use if you're just starting out learning to use this tool. Well, there you have it. Now you know how to use master pages in Affinity Publisher. But what about the rest of the process, actually creating a low content book from scratch? Well, if you click on the link in the description below, you can download my free guide, 3 Steps to Publishing Your First Low Content Book in Less Than a Day. And also, if you'd like to join a like-minded group of individuals who are also on their low content publishing journey, you can join my free Facebook by clicking on the other link in the description below as well. Check out these videos next for some more Affinity Publisher design tutorials. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button. Be sure to subscribe and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.